Hey everybody. So Jeff Lafferty, how's it going out there? Just doing a quick test. My new webcam. I had some trouble with my webcam over the weekend, so I had to get a different one. What I think happened was it just taped it down. This thing that where I film from so often that it kind of actually abraded the cord a little bit. And anyway, I went to do the Arcast on Friday and I couldn't fire it up, so thought I should do a little test, see if it's gonna work. Before I try to do the show on Monday. I couldn't face, honestly, doing the work I'm supposed to be doing right now. So I'm kind of playing around with this little oil painting. Sometimes I just need to, like, decompress, you know? And this is one of those days, man. This was gonna be like a Red Sonja kind of piece, and I had her like with like huge boobs, and her hair was a lot more red, and I toned the boobs down. I like it a lot more now, and I don't know, I think it's coming along. I like doing these pieces. I mean, they're just fun. They're nothing. They take no work, you know. And so that's why I like doing them sometimes. And they're just like stuff I like to paint, you know. Girl with sword and stuff like that, you know. It's just fun stuff, you know. If it comes out, I'll put it on eBay, but who knows? I might mess it up too. Going through some of my stuff, and I noticed I actually have a couple of these sitting around. Got this one, which actually came out really cool. This giant, the girl down here. I can't really see that well, but never sold that one. I might stick that on eBay too. Maybe make a print of it or something. Came across this one, just kind of like Hercules and the Lion. I never got around to painting that. I was thinking that might be a fun one to paint up. That's just kind of like the underpainting, which is in acrylic and stuff. So, yeah, I don't know. They're my stress out paintings. When I'm like stressing to like ninth degree, this is what I do. I think it's because it's like, you know, this is the kind of stuff I used to do in my sketchbook a lot, and they just, you know, I don't know. It's like comfort food in a way. But yeah, I have like a big job. I have a couple big jobs going right now, and that I need to be like working on, and I only have a couple hours right now. It's like the middle of the night. Time is at 4:32. Which, I don't know, it's just been a stressful week. I don't want to go into the stuff that's going on, I guess. Generally, that kind of sucks. Bring it up like this and then you're like, I don't want to tell you guys. Actually listening to a soundtrack on my headphones, it's kind of weird. They usually just sit here and you know, talk and paint. I don't know. It's kind of cool. It's the soundtrack for Empire Strikes Back. It's just in my, you know, in with my music, and I just like clicked it on random. So it's just playing like everything on my whole computer right now. That's like more comfort food. So I have like all my, I don't know, some, you know, you save your favorite stuff, and so it's just going through like all these, you know, like I said, random audio thing. Just playing some Blondie a little bit ago, which is really cool. Some Journey, big Journey fan. It's just a lot, you know. And then it'll switch over to like, you know, Last of the Mohegan Strand soundtrack or something. Which is kinda cool. Pat Benatar's on here. That kind of music always gets me, for some reason, thinking about high school, which I guess that's when it was coming out, so of course it's gonna remind me of that. But my girlfriend in high school really was into music. I wasn't as much, but she got me into different stuff just because I was always listening to it with her. She used to have like this, God, I can't remember what the car was. I want to say it was like an Impala, like, man, I don't know, but not like the cool ones. It's like when they got to be like these gigantic boats. I might be wrong, that it might not have been one of those, but one of those big old boat cars you get as a kid. The damn thing would like break down just constantly, and then if you left it alone it would start back up later. And, I don't know, it was always breaking down around town, and then we'd just, like, leave it somewhere, and we'd come back, and, you know, somebody'd be getting ready to tow it, or the cops would be there, and she'd jump in and start it up, and we, you know, get out of trouble. It was pretty funny. She used to have, like, all these 8-tracks in there, too. Because the thing only had an 8-track player, and they were all like her sisters, you know, older sisters' tapes and stuff, so it was like all this really lame stuff, like, I'm trying to think, like Crystal Gale and stuff like that. But, you know, that's all we had in the car, so we'd go around listening to those 8-tracks. I don't know if you could buy 8-tracks at that point. You know, it was like 84 or something. They might have actually already been gone, but yeah, I don't know. Crazy, like, young love, you know. It's cool. It's a cool time. Everybody should have something like that. I don't really know whatever happened to her either. I mean, you know, we broke up like when I was 20 or something, so, you know, she's like my high school girlfriend. So I don't even know where she's at. She's probably got a different name by now, I'd imagine. Hope it worked out for her, whatever she's doing. This is kicking on some Lita Ford now. Don't judge my music, goddammit. I know I listen to lame stuff. I listen to what I like. I don't really listen to much of this stuff anymore. I think it's because, like, when I did construction, you know, like, classic rock was, like, always on the radio, so I've got a bunch of it, but I never listen to it because, well, because usually I was sick of it, because, you know, Usually I'd be like, out of my ear, Wheel of Time, One More Time, I'm gonna shoot myself. I haven't been hanging out doing construction for a while, so. Yeah, I went out and helped my dad this weekend, and my brother, and I put this big shed back up. Got blew over in the wind, basically. Turned that down a bit. But yeah, it's pretty crazy. I kind of wish I'd brought my camera. It's this huge metal shed. That's like way too big to lift, you know. I don't know how big this thing is. It's like 10 feet tall and about. It's got to be like 24 feet long or something, probably. It's all made out of steel. It's all bolted together. And the thing is, it's kind of like a big half circle almost. And these things are just, they're so bad about catching the wind. They're just like a big sail and they'll blow over. So a couple different times, like no matter how we anchor these things down, like, you know, this crazy Colorado, you know. It wasn't a tornado that came through, but you know, you get some really righteous winds out there. And yeah, anyway, the wind came by one day and blew it over, rolled it over. Didn't kill anything, thank goodness, but you know, it's funny. It's like we looked it over and it looked okay, like we could set it back up. So Keith, my brother, he got the Bobcat out and put the bucket on the front of it and like lifted it up, basically got underneath it and lifted it up and got it up high enough that it was completely off the ground. It's hard to explain, but he put it in the center so that the sides kind of were hanging. And when he lifted it, they kind of straightened out because they were just kind of hanging. And then we like set it back down where we wanted it and, you know, dug some post holes and all this stuff and put the fence back up. And it's hard work, though. I haven't done work like that since I was a kid, you know. I can't remember last time I had to dig a post hole. So tiring. But yeah, I kind of wish I'd have brought my camera. So it was pretty awesome to see Keith lift that thing up with the Bobcat. I thought he was going to kill himself. I think he was thinking he was going to kill all of us because he kept yelling at me to watch out for Tristan and, you know, watch what I was, where I was and stuff. Because you kind of had to get underneath it to, I don't know, straighten out the sides and screw them all down and stuff, so it's pretty hairy. It's funny though, you know, it's like you're so close with your family, you know, when you grow up, you know, because you live with your brother and stuff, you know, and my dad, of course, but then you don't see him as much when you get older, you know, you kind of lose track of him, what they're doing. But then, you know, just anything like that happens and it's like we're all back together, just, you know, just like it was before. And my dad had like a heart attack, I guess it's been 2 years ago, so he's been kind of having trouble with this thing he's got in his chest now. It's like a pacemaker, but they call it something else. And it just sucks, man. Yeah, it just sucks. Yeah, I left one video public last week, and, you know, like usual, got trolled up, by one guy, basically. I say trolls, I should just say troll, because there's pretty much only one of them. But he is there, man. He is there. He's my biggest fan, I think. He watches my every move. But yeah, he showed up to spit his bile all over my fucking videos like usual. He's calling me a fucking redneck and shit. Which is pretty funny. I guess he figures he's like superior than me because I'm from the West or something, you know?
He's like a bully he's like a bully in high school, but you can't
do anything about it. You know, like in high school, you could have like, you know, well, we used to go down by the river to fight, but you know what I mean? You can't do that because we're like adults and he doesn't live here, you know? There's no way to settle it. So it's just like, you know, this constant thing, you know? Just get up one morning and it's like, oh, surprise. Yeah. Surprise, I've trolled up your shit. Yeah, I really hate that guy. Fucking hate him. I don't really hate people. It takes a lot for me to hate people. I might complain a lot, but I'm not a hater. But man, this guy just won't quit. And it's just so different than like, you need to put something up on some forum and somebody comes along and says, oh, the head doesn't look right or something, or I don't like your whatever. You know, it's just completely different. It's not even criticism. It's just like meanness, you know? It's constantly, you know. And then, like, I noticed, too, he's like, now his new thing is to go around, because he can't really get to me as much, because I'm not on YouTube as much. And he'll, like, you know, he'll make message my friends and shit. And, so it's expanding out, you know. Guy's a fucking asshole. And it all started, I mean, trying to think back, you know, because I actually tried to friend the guy, you know. He, in the beginning, you know, he just was a fan, just a random, you know, guy leaving comments. And, you know, I just talked back to him like anybody. And, oh man, you know. I wish I would have done that. Because it just went so sour, man. Yeah, I hate talking about trolls, too, because I know everybody gets sick of it, but part of me just wants to put it out there like a warning in a way, you know? Because I had no idea. I had no idea what this was going to be like, you know? Because people go, oh, trolls, you get like stupid comments on like YouTube. Yeah, I get those too, you know? This ain't what this is. This ain't what this is. Just imagine, like, you know, you sort of suspect that the guy's like a serial killer. And he's paying total attention to you. And maybe I'm blowing that out of proportion, but that's what it feels like. That's what it feels like, you know. I go around the house and like double lock all the fucking doors, you know. Check my closet, make sure everything's in there. Just because you don't know, you feel like this guy's gonna pop up anywhere. And fuck with like your family and your kids and everything else, you know. I mean, if I could, you know, read you some of the emails, man. And then, what's funny is it's like, as soon as it started happening, it's like, there's other people, other guys on YouTube, just like me, do videos. I'm not going to say any of their names, because I don't want to put it out there, but they're going through the same fucking thing, and have went through it with this guy for years, really.
But he's got a podcast, and I'm like the star of it. You go over and listen to it. It's all about me.
I haven't listened to it for quite a while because I couldn't take it, you know. But, yeah. Me and some other guys are the star of his world, which is pretty funny. I bet he's just loving this too, just hearing this whole thing. Cream in his jeans right now.
This other guy, he actually had to call the police on this motherfucker. If you can believe that.
Didn't stop him. I don't know, you know. I just keep deleting his comments, you know. And, he just keeps leaving them. And then, like, last night, you know, I did the worst thing that I could do. Or not last night. It was a little while ago. I guess I'm feeling like it's the next day because I see the light coming through the window, but.
Yeah, it's. I fucking, like, you know, emailed him, told him to fucking knock his shit off.
Stop fucking with me, which I've done this before, and doesn't work. You know, just charges him back up. Fucking dude. And you know what's funny is it's like, you know, since the guy like stalks the fuck out of me, I've like looked at him online. It's like all this weird shit, but you know, one thing is he's like supposedly is like a Christian. You know, it's just like one more thing. It's like sometimes I just hate being Christian because of like all the fucking horrible stuff that they're all doing in the name of like Christianity. And it's just like, I just want to believe in God, you know? I just want something to hang on to that seems real, you know, in this crazy world where nothing seems right, you know? Anyway, so I picked this one for whatever reason, because my parents were it or whatever. But it's just like, you know, all this bad stuff that goes along with it, the other people do that have nothing to do with me. But anyway, this guy of all guys, this guy, you know, says he's a Christian and like all this stuff, prays, I guess, who knows. And you're just like, man, you're like the meanest motherfucker I've ever met, you know, not ever met, that's not true. It's mean in a very cowardly way, which is the internet, you know. I've met guys who are really mean in real life. He's not like that, I guess. Or I would guess he's not.
I have no idea.
But anyway, it's like, how can you be that way, you know? He seems to have just no mercy whatsoever. That's what, like, Christianity's all about, mercy. At least from my perspective, but I guess that's the thing, is nobody's looking at it from my perspective. They're all like, you know, well, I don't want to start that shit. I was going to say they're all like, hate the gays and abortion and all that, but that's not really true. Some of them are, but it's just like, you know, anything, Muslims, there's always like the bad seeds and things like that, you know. can't throw out, you know, the baby with the bathwater kind of thing. How did I start talking about religion? I don't know. But it just cracks me up, man. You know, that he can say that with one hand, and then, like, on the next hand, he's setting up, like, six different, like, YouTube accounts with, like, fake names. So that he can, like, troll me six times for my last video. It's like, come on, man.
Yeah. I was just thinking, actually, it's funny, you know, it's like I kind of forgot, but...
Well, I just remembered, like, actually when it did start. And, I guess in a way I did insult him.
I made this video.
I don't know, should I say this? So it's basically, I have to say it all over again. That's what made him mad the first time, I guess. But I made this video a long time ago. Somebody linked me to, you know, Kevin Cross and his 100 Days of Comics. Well, he trolls him too. Hopefully Kevin won't get mad about me bringing that up.
But he made this webcomic called, 30 Days of Doing Nothing, which is like a parody comic of him.
And, I just thought it was like super poor taste, you know. And so I pretty much said that on the video. I said the guy's name. And I remember he messaged me later and was pretty much asking me to take it down. I can't remember the exact thing. And, I think that was the first time he threatened me, because he likes to threaten me, like, you know, like, if you mention my name, I'm gonna, like, sue you. Because I guess he's got, like, some brother who's, like, a lawyer. So I guess, you know, they're waiting in the wings to, like, take my palatial mansion here and stuff, and send my kids to the poorhouse.
Because God forbid I would, you know, out the guy. Anyway, he put up this shitty webcomic that's, you know, if you go read it, it's fucking, you know,
it's ridiculously insulting. And, you know, but, I mean, it's a good example of what the guy does, because he just wastes his time doing this all the time. And, you know. So anyway, I felt like I was kind of smashing a bug under my heel, because, you know, who is this guy? He's nobody, right?
I mean, that's probably a lot of it, why this all happens, is because it's just jealousy, you know? It's like, I have, like, somewhat of an audience on YouTube. He doesn't have one, so... He just gotta do this shit, right? And,
So anyway, he asked me to take it down, and I ended up taking it down, because, like, you know, I have mercy. I don't wanna, you know, like I said, squash a bug under my heel if I can't help it. I think... If I didn't known what was coming, I might have been like, you know what, you deal with it. But I didn't, and I took the video down. There's like one video, if you go back, that is, you know, that skips over in like the, you know, whatever, my 200 videos of the ArtCast. And that's the one. That was it.
I took that down because he asked me to. And, you know, just had no idea, like,
that I was sort of like the next one, you know, in his sights. But, you know, he got called out on it, so. But it's weird, I went around and, you know, you're just like, what the hell, right? And I started searching, like, his name and stuff, and just seeing, like, what's up. Because, like, you know, other people told me some shit about him now. Just in the crowd I'm in. because it's like there's a lot of people who have gotten like trolled by this guy, and oh man, you know. So it's like he's like he's got a, I mean I think he's got like 1,000, you know, fake names and shit. But anyway, on one of them, it's like he does like on Amazon, find these, they're like transvestite comics. And, which actually is fine. You know, I don't really care. It's like, I don't care which way you swing or whatever. But yeah, that was funny. I find those, and, you know. He's, I don't.
What am I saying here? I think the thing is, though, is like, they're bad. They're so badly drawn and shit. I think that's another thing. Now I feel like I'm picking on the guy, but I mean, he's picked on me so long that I feel like picking back a little bit. There was this one time I remember in high school where I think it was like, this was more like junior high. When I first got into junior high, and there was just these kids, man, that just would not leave me alone for like the first part of that first year. And they were just, you know, they were a year above me, and they all kind of hung out in a group. So, what were you supposed to do, you know? And they just were picking on me and my friends, like, mercilessly, you know, unmercifully. And there was one day we were all going into, like, the auditorium, and we were, like, this big fucking line, and they were, like, saying some shit on the back of the line. And I just, like, snapped, you know? And I turned around, I start flipping them off and calling them assholes, because there was like a big line and the teachers were like watching us all going in. So they couldn't like get to me. I start screaming back there, "You're fucking dead. I'm gonna fucking get you. I'm gonna kill you." It didn't matter, because I was like, I was just so had it. I was like, you guys picked on me enough, man. And, it was kind of funny because everybody in the school, kind of, not the school, but like everybody in the vicinity knew what was going on. And it made those guys look like fucking fools and bullies. And they didn't stop picking on me, but everybody laughed at their ass that day. Because there's no way to win this. There's no way to win this. Making this video talking about this shit is not winning it. This will just get me a lot more grief. And all that kind of good stuff. But anyway, back to what I was going to say about his tranny comics, because they're so bad. It'd be like one thing if you're doing like really good tranny comics. I could respect that. But man, it's like you need to work on your comics, man. You need to work on your drawing. It's just like really kind of crappy digital art that looks like it's all just 100% traced. I have no idea if that's his technique, but I don't know, man. And then he's got like this business that's like this custom comics business that he's always talking about. He's making all this money, and I don't think it makes anything. I think, I from what I've understood, it sounds like he might be on some sort of like, you know, like somebody's paying his bills for him or something. I mean, just to have the time on his hands to troll the fuck out of me and other people, you'd think he'd have to be home all day. But yeah, I don't know, man. I'm really tempted to like say his name, but I don't know. I think I won't. I mean, if anybody wants to message me, if they feel like they're getting trolled by somebody, you know, anybody else on YouTube, like Jonathan Rector, or anybody else, you know, making videos, Gary Anderson, or, I don't know, I don't want to name everybody making videos, but there's a good chance you're getting, you know, possibly trolled, or getting, gonna get ready to, you know, if you say the wrong thing to this fucker.
Because that's like his, that's pretty much his MO. He's like a podcast troll. Everybody that has been fucked with by this guy has done a podcast, you know? And it's probably about comics or art, which is weird. But yeah, just message me. I'll tell you exactly what I'm talking about. You know, I'll tell you all the stories. I'll start reading emails. you'll shit yourself. And then I'll tell you some other stuff that hasn't happened to me, it's happened to other people. I don't know. I remember, like, the last time, like, this really happened. I mean, just happened a little bit, and it sent me kind of into, like, oh, man, I hate this shit, because something else is happening that's kind of reminding me of this. But the last time it happened, man, it's like, my brother, he had these, like, lumps. My younger brother, of all things, you know? A baby brother, you know? It's this kid's, like, grown up. I've seen him get, you know, ever since he was little. He's 15 years younger than me, so he's like, it's almost like my kid again, you know? But he had these damn lumps they found, and getting like tested to see if he has cancer and shit. And thank God he doesn't, you know? But this is a while ago, and I didn't know that at the time. Went through this like 3-week period of just like fucking waiting. And every day, you know, I get on the stupid R-cast and stuff, and I'm like talking about all this random shit, and all I can do is like think about that, you know? And it's like, oh yeah, here comes fucking Dan. Right in the middle of that shit, you know? And all I could think of was like, who fucking cares, dude? Who fucking cares, you know? My kid brother like fucking keels over just so you can like throw out your stupid insults, you know? Fucking bozo. Well, anyway, that's like not a good webcam test. What am I fucking thinking? Anyway, I guess it works. Play this back and see if it actually recorded anything.